July 2009. The Russian government declassifies top secret documents detailing USO encounters with the Russian Navy. Stunning first-hand accounts of extraterrestrial encounters shock the Russian people and ignite interest from the world's UFO research community. But how could such compelling accounts have been kept secret for so long? And why?
The problem that we had in the Soviet era prior to 1992, you're dealing with fundamentally a totalitarian system in which UFOs and USOs were not to be talked about. So there was a lot of secrecy. And with the end of the Soviet Union and the release of some of those files that we now have had access to, one of them concerns an undated account of a Russian submarine in the South Pacific.
A Russian nuclear sub encountered a formation of what appeared to be alien spacecraft at depth under the water.
At a depth of approximately 260 meters, crew aboard a fully weaponized Russian nuclear submarine detect six unknown objects on their sonar, traveling in formation directly towards them. What's even more alarming is the speed at which the objects are traveling, in excess of 265 miles per hour.
This was hugely unnerving for these highly trained military personnel, and it was quite unlike anything they'd ever seen or experienced before.
Six disc-shaped objects traveling in formation continue on their trajectory, gaining speed as they head directly towards the submarine.
They were going at incredible speeds, but then when the submarine became alarmed at what was happening with these objects and slowed down its speed, the objects did exactly the same thing, mirroring what the submarine was doing.
The Russian crew are at first stunned by what they're witnessing, then quickly man their battle stations.
The captain, fearing that a collision was imminent and that he was under attack, ordered an emergency surfacing of the submarine.
The submarine finally breaches the surface, narrowly avoiding a collision. But what happens next is even more astonishing.
So here's the Soviet submarine commander dealing with this terrifying situation. They then saw through the periscope these six objects come out of the water and take off at some absurdly fast speed.
One can only speculate about the intent of these USOs. Was this a hostile act of some sort, or were they just fleeing detection? We don't know.
Researchers believe what the Russians encountered was a squadron of underwater extraterrestrial spacecraft.
If you can travel that fast underwater, water is just another medium, so their craft can fly underwater just like they can above water. That tells me that these aren't conventional technology. It's nothing earthly made.
What we're dealing with here is very clearly advanced technology. So we have to draw the conclusion that perhaps this is some sort of extraterrestrial technology that we're dealing with. That's what makes this case so compelling. The speed, the movement of the objects, and the rate that they disappeared. It's incredible.
However, the most chilling encounter revealed in Russia's declassified reports doesn't involve unidentified submersible objects, but the alien creatures believed to inhabit them. Siberia, 1982. With a depth of 1,642 meters, Lake Baikal is the deepest freshwater lake in the world. Russian Navy divers are conducting a research mission. Given the depth of the lake and its frigid temperature, little is known about what lies beneath the surface. Seven Russian divers are at a depth of 50 meters when suddenly the frogmen realize they are being watched.
These strange humanoid figures were much bigger than human beings and appeared to be wearing helmets of some sort. What on earth are we to make of an encounter like this? It's one thing to talk about USOs, but quite another to talk about humanoid entities deep in the lake.
These were large beings, human-shaped, but like 9 feet tall, wearing what seemed like very tight-fitting silvery suits. Not your normal scuba gear, basically, swimming in the water, what they've come to call the swimmers of Lake Baikal.
What were these creatures? Why did they not seem to use what we would be using to sustain life? There were no oxygen tanks. So there are lots of interesting facets to this. You have creatures that are underwater and surviving with technology that we don't comprehend.
The Russian divers then make a fateful decision. They try to capture one.
The divers attempted to capture one of these creatures, but at this point, so the documents say, the entities reacted.
A powerful, unknown force suddenly propels the entire group of divers up from the deep water to the surface.
They did a rapid rise to the surface of the water. Well, when you do that too fast, you suffer from decompression and you get the bends, and it's deadly. There were 7 of these divers, and 3 of them died. And 4 were very severely injured as a result of this.
Why did these creatures react the way that they did? I have to think that when we began to act aggressively, when the divers wanted to capture one of these creatures and throw a net over it, that perhaps they were reacting in a defensive way when they expelled the divers to the surface.
If we can believe what we've read in the reports, these are extraterrestrial beings, something otherworldly.
Could these Lake Baikal creatures really be from another world, as UFO researchers believe? According to Russian documents, the surviving divers were too shaken to speak about the incident. But researchers believe the Russian government prevented them from speaking out. And if that's the case, what could they have been trying to keep secret?
They would be concerned about the potential threat, but they'd also be intrigued to know what these entities were, what the technology that they possessed was, and of course, could they acquire that technology themselves? And indeed, weaponization is always something at the back of the mind of any government official looking at the UFO and indeed USO mystery. If there's a technology down there more advanced than our own, we want it.
UFO investigators believe the Lake Baikal encounter indicates that extraterrestrials may be able to survive frigid water, and that interaction with them comes with risks. But if that's true, where was their craft? Is it possible they've constructed bases deep below the surface?
The oceans are about as remote a place as you can get on this planet. If you want to conduct yourself on a world secretly without a lot of interference, it's actually ideal.
We know less about the deep ocean than we do about the surface of the moon or Mars. It's a complete mystery.
Logically, it makes complete sense to actually hide stuff underwater because it would be very hard for a hostile government to actually find an alien base of some kind under the water. You've got all that protection, the mud, the silt, keeps any visual recognition from happening, so it really makes a lot of sense.